Operator overloading allows operators to be redefined and used, where one or both of the operands are of a certain class. When done correctly, this can simplify the code and make user-defined types as easy to use as the simple types. In this example, there is a class called minum with an integer field, and a constructor for setting that field. There is also a static add method that adds two minum objects together, and returns the result as a new minum object. Two minum instances can be added together using the add method. What operator overloading does is to simplify this syntax, and thereby provide a more intuitive interface for the class. To convert the add method to an overload method for the addition sign, replace the name of the method with the operator keyword, followed by the operator that is to be overloaded. The white space between the keyword and the operator can optionally be left out. Note that for an operator overloading method to work, it must be defined as both public and static. Since the class now overloads the addition sign, this operator can be used to perform the required calculation. Addition is a binary operator, because it takes two operands. To overload a unary operator, such as increment, a single method parameter is used instead. Note that this method will overload both the postfix and prefix versions of the increment operator. When overloading a unary operator, the return type and parameter type must be of the enclosing type. On the other hand, when overloading most binary operators, the return type can be anything, except for void, and only one of the parameters must be of the enclosing type. This means that it is possible to further overload a binary operator with other method parameters, for example to allow a minum and an int to be added together. C# allows overloading of almost all operators, as can be seen in this table. The combined assignment operators cannot be explicitly overloaded. Instead, they are implicitly overloaded when their corresponding arithmetic or bitwise operators are overloaded. The comparison operators, as well as true and false, must be overloaded in pairs. For example, overloading the equal operator means that the not equal operator also has to be overloaded. Notice that true and false are considered to be operators. By overloading them, objects of the class can be used in conditional statements where the object needs to be evaluated as a Boolean type. When overloading them, the return types must be bool.